everybody. Hello. Hi, everyone. Okie dokie. Fuck yeah. And a beautiful Monday to you as well. Believe it or not, to you listeners out there, there's a packed crowd here tonight.
Yeah.
How fun.
Standing room.
Another beautiful day. Fucking.
Is this thing getting lower? This thing hanging from the ceiling? Because I swear to God, I don't remember being that low.
There's a whole thing going on. It turns out these $1 Chinese balls fall apart very easily.
Yeah.
I keep them in the trunk of my car, and I can't. The way I go through traffic, like, it's such a joke that I have these. I could have folded them in on themselves. I could have taken the extra, you know, about 4 seconds to do that and preserve them because they all just fold up. But after the show, I'm just like, what the fuck? And I throw it back there, and the sword's bouncing around with them, and it breaks them.
You should have. I mean, if they were only a dollar, you should probably have bought like 400.
This one was $10.
Oh, yeah.
And I needed to have it.
Is that like, do you protect this one more than the other ones? Like, do you keep this one in the back seat?
Oh, I always fold that. That one folds up easier than the really rinky dinky ones. But I need to get more. We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
Patriot, bring some Iron Patriots here, everybody. Our head of security here. As all. There he is.
Hey, do you think we'll ever really have a barbecue roast ever? Because you said that's about barbecue roast.
Well, that's what it means. He's talking about the translation of the favorite of the hanging.
See, I like to think it's just roast, like we're roasting people, kind of. And and Tony's noting for the roast. So
yeah, well, I saw that one specifically. There must have been like 50 of them hanging, and I didn't want to bother these Chinese people that were working there. Even though, you know, that's what they do, is they sell these hanging things. Chinatown's amazing, by the way. I need to tell you guys that. Go there some afternoon with a couple hours to kill. It's so much fun. It's different than other shitty mini towns of different cultures. Everybody tries to pull that off, but the Chinese are really good at it. Kind of a nice lunch. You walk around, see all these freaky Chinese. They're all like missing limbs and shit. It's like so crazy. Fun.
Found out something crazy today. I talk about the Olive Garden a lot on a lot of the podcasts I do. It's kind of like an inside joke that's been going on for about a year and a half. I bring it up on the Joe Rogan podcast almost every episode of Death Squad. Somehow I try to sneak an Olive Garden.
You're notorious.
Reference.
You've done more advertising for Olive Garden than they have.
Right. And so they found a way to hire me but not hire me. They now have a thing where every Death Squad and Joe Rogan podcast, they sponsor it on YouTube, and so they throw their advertising in front of it now. So now if you watch like a Joe Rogan podcast and there's a commercial, 90% of the time it's going to be Olive Garden.
Get the fuck out of here.
And I get no money for that.
Sorry. You know what's next, right?
Right.
They're just going to come straight to you.
Right. Well, I hope so.
With just all-you-can-eat tickets galore.
Well,
you're going to have so many never-ending pasta bowls.
See, I don't think so. I think they found a way not to pay me. So I think from now on, if you guys saw this on YouTube, if you're watching this on YouTube and you saw a commercial before, Olive Garden is the shittiest food that you'll ever, ever eat.
Oh, how dare you.
I had allegedly heard that there's shit in every single one of their fucking meals. They put a little... Actually, there's a Vice documentary you have to watch. It's called Poop Tea. I guess in Korea, back in the day, they used to make this poop tea out of kids' poop. They take like a 7-year-old kid's poop, put it in some water, let it ferment, whatever that word is, and they like cook it overnight and stuff like that. And this poor Vice reporter from Japan was like trying to investigate this poop tea, and she had to drink it. And it is the grossest documentary you'll ever see, and it will be another thing to add to what the fuck is wrong with Asian people.
How did we go from Olive Garden to that?
Because it tastes the same. That's how, Tommy.
Oh, my God. Holy shit.
Allegedly.
I got to give it to you, Brian. You are the only man in show business that avidly goes after his advertisers.
But I didn't think...
You want to be part of this?
You know what? I do. The only shit I get from Olive Garden is people give me Olive Garden gift cards and breadsticks. So I do get stuff from the Olive Garden, like but not... From the Olive Garden.
They physically bring you
breadsticks? Yeah, they come to shows and they think it's cute to give me like a gift certificate, which is nice, but I'm not going to eat at that shitty restaurant that many times, so. Just kidding.
I like those breadsticks. I'd like to dip them in the Alfredo sauce.
Yeah.
They're good.
Yeah, the Alfredo dipping sauce is pretty amazing.
Yeah, that's pretty. That'll put a smile on your face every time.
Perfect hangover food.
Right.
Well, yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah,
man.
I like that Ice Ass Chronicles that you guys did on Friday with Jason Tebalt. I hadn't seen him in a long time.
Yeah.
That's fun. Yeah, that was a good one.
We had
really fun one on
Friday. Yeah, and Tony, I heard that you liked the show House of Cards, and I wanted to tell you I watched all 13 episodes of that back in February.
Heck yeah.
Do you know that girl on there, Kate Mara? The real hot girl, the little reporter girl that Kevin Spacey had a good time with?
Yes.
She was on American Horror Story. Did you ever see her on that show?
No.
She didn't really turn me on that, but man, she made me go crazy on House of Cards.
Wow.
Jeez. Was that
a woo? Those are some cute little feet on that.
We have learned about this growing foot fetish.
And you know what I want to say is, I noticed on the Joe Rogan Experience that I'm not alone, because Grapefruit Simmons, he likes feet too.
That's true. He is. He was
AKA Greg Fitzsimmons.
Yeah. You should send him a picture of your feet, see what he does. Just,
you
know, like
an
experiment.
Like,
yeah, but who knows? Maybe, like, if you like a foot fetish, you probably go buy on feet. It's not like that foot's going to fuck you. You just love the beauty of a foot.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I don't know if that's how that works.
Are you sure?
Would you put a guy's foot in your mouth?
No, I don't. I like the cute girl's feet, like the ballerina or the, you know, like the massage during a nice movie or something. Nothing kinky. You know, you could just appreciate a cute girl's foot. I mean,
when you dated the when you had your African American girlfriend back in Texas, did you ever play with her?
No, we just flirted around. We didn't actually do anything, but. Red Band, you said you liked that Miley Cyrus.
Wait,
wait a second. That was a quick segue there.
You want to get out of that, don't you? You didn't like her feet, did you? Were they dry?
They weren't really my style.
Oh, she just didn't take care
of
them.
But I'll tell you one thing
when you say
about the female brothers is I do like Halle Berry's feet. Halle Berry has some cute feet.
What, the female brothers?
What does that mean?
Damn. You know who has bad feet? I'm going to tell you who has bad feet. I was on one of the last episodes of Hannah Montana as an extra, and Miley Cyrus has some ugly feet.
What?
Whoa. Ugly. And you would think they would be cute because she has it, and Selena Gomez, she has some ugly feet. I saw her on a Sears commercial. And you would think that they would, because you see their face and you go down the body, you think, ooh, these are going to be good. And then you go, oh, no, that ain't good.
Wait a second. How old was she in this episode?
What, are you trying to make me out to be an old man pervert?
Well, I mean, like, isn't that show when she was 15 or 14?
Well, no, it was one of the last episodes. It was right before it ended. So she was already ready to, to get crazy.
Are you trying to make me look like a pervert? Is that what you're doing? And meanwhile, he's like, oh, yeah, she was 14.
No, it was right at the end. So, you know, she was getting to where she wanted to go crazy.
I mean, she was starting to develop a little.
Yeah. Yeah, did you see that video as she got in the alphabet soup? It spells out twerk in the little spoon, his little cute part. And then they cut some fingers off and some Pepto-Bismol shoots out.
That is a great video.
You know, and do you have to be a big butt to twerk, or can the skinny girls twerk too?
No, they can't twerk.
Can they?
No. Is Sarah dressed as Sarah?
What happens if they, what happens if they try?
Kidding. Huh?
What happens if they try? Like, what comes out?
Sadness? I don't know.
But that song really was for Rihanna. And it's a house party. It sounds like a love song, but it's about a house party where all kinds of debauchery is going on.
Well, no, everyone's on Molly. You've done Molly.
Yeah, right? I'm talking about that in the song. I did mushrooms one time a long time ago. But, I haven't done it in a long time, but
what
maybe
happened?
I'll be going to Joshua Tree with you next year.
Yeah, that'd be great. You got to wear the suit.
Yeah. Hopefully I'll have air conditioning by then.
When you did do mushrooms, how'd that go for you?
Oh, it was very deep, man. I mean, I've always been pondering the mysteries of the universe. I mean, you do realize, Tony, you're inside your own bubble, and I'm inside my own bubble. And we're each filtering in our perception of reality through our belief system.
Fuck yeah, everybody. There you go.
It's like, dude, you might not see the same thing I see tomorrow. You might see Obama get assassinated, and I don't even see that shit.
Whoa, now we're...
It's an example.
Wait a second. Fuck. Why would any of us see that?
It's just an example, but when you see me...
Oh, my God.
It's just an example.
Do you guys realize that if Obama got assassinated tomorrow, we're all going to prison?
Do you guys understand both you saying that now put Death Squad on some kind of government list?
Yeah.
No, but what I'm saying is, in my reality, I wouldn't even be seeing that. It would be a normal day where Obama's going around smiling and it's normal. But I adjust around, you would see my image adjust that I agreed that I saw the same thing on the news.
Now, one of the things that we noticed last week is that an interesting fun fact about the Patriot is that the actual, if there is, say, a human being under there, he's from Texas, and he...
What if we, like, took off his helmet once,
and it was just there's a fucking there. Robot?
I could compare it to, I'm kind of like a turtle. I'm inside a shell. I'm like a little turtle in here.
What if it was just Chip and Dale on each other's shoulders the whole time?
No, I'm about 5'11".
Well, he's from Texas, and we noticed that he's accidentally racist at times.
No, I'm not.
It's kind of like hanging out with your grandmother.
Like you like the brothers? He calls black women female brothers.
I guess I should say the sisters, but then you might think it's some other kind of sisters. The chocolate sisters.
Just take off the E. By the way, the other words.
This is what I'm talking about when I say accidental racism. He's got good intentions. He has no idea what he says.
Don't get us off to a bad start because Willie Hunter's on tonight. We don't want to get on a bad start.
Oh, see, that makes it weird, too, that you would say that. Yeah. That's another example of accidental racism.
Yeah.
Like, you're just trying to be positive and move on, but you don't realize that how it comes across.
You know what
well,
was
we
so,
don't
want to
talk about
so
the
crazy?
Brothers. Willie Hunter's coming on tonight.
What was so crazy today is I happened to get on a bus that was earlier than the one I usually get on, and at the Orange and Sunset.
Wait, don't give away anybody's address here, Patriot.
No, at the Orange stop. Willie got on. I was like, "That's the guest on our show tonight."
Wait a second, you shared the bus tonight with our guest?
Yes.
Well, you know what? We might as well just bring him up and get him right into the mix.
Yeah.
Tonight's guest is. One of my best friends, one of the funniest people I know, the future of whatever he wants to do in all of comedy. One of my smartest pals. He's a writer on Dion Cole's Black Box. He's also a producer on that show. And he's a regular host here at the Comedy Store. Put your hands together for my pal, the one and only, the great Willie Hunter.
Red cause I'm sweaty, bodies everywhere. Hands in the air like we don't care. Cause we came to have so much fun now.
The great Willie Hunter, everyone. I purposefully just sat down second because, and you're the first guest that I've ever done that for because you're so old school late night that I thought maybe you'd get a kick out of sitting down first.
Thank you.
Willie's one of my funniest pals.
I don't know what to say after that.
He has an amazing like old school style to him, meets new school, and... He's always fun. Willie, what's been going on? When you saw the Iron Patriot on the bus, and you knew you were coming to do this show, I was very excited. Like, what went through your mind?
I said, oh, we're doing a show together.
You said that to him?
Yeah.
And what'd he say? What'd you say in your words?
I said, what's up? I gave him a little knuckles. But the thing is, he didn't get off at the same exit as me. I was going to escort him in style to the club and have a little conversation, but... he got off on another stop.
He waited an extra stop so he didn't have to walk
in. No, I got off
in.
Early. Oh. I didn't want to be seen with him.
Oh, you got off at a laugh come factory.
Come on, the Patriot's our friend.
I'm sure the Patriot...
In private.
In
public, we don't know each other.
Can I ask you something, Willie?
Sure.
I went to your Twitter page and I saw a black man and I knew I recognized the picture and I typed in Google black tennis player and it was Arthur Ashe. Is he like a hero of yours? Because he has a fascinating life. I read about him on Wikipedia today.
Wow.
How many black people do you know?
No, I didn't know he contracted AIDS in the early
80s. All right, that's
another moment in accidental racism with the Iron Patriot.
It was from a blood transfusion.
Hey, we got to figure out. What we got to do right now is we have to figure out a new sound effect.
Accidental racist.
From now on.
I don't know if I should be up here.
It's great. It's beautiful. Nobody better. Another fun fact why this is even doubly great is because Willie's one of my friends who I always... We have been marinating in this chamber known as the Comedy Store for at least together half a decade, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's been over 5 years since I've been out here.
Yeah. And he's one of the guys that I always do black jokes in front of. Sometimes I pretend like he's not there. A lot of the times when he's walking in, when it's me and a few white guys, always, yeah, because he's black. You know what I mean? I always make a point, and it's always a, and we, it's probably our biggest inside joke. Well, I mean, we have a lot, but one of the bigger ones is that I don't mind being racist to you because you have the best sense of humor.
I think it's because I just say silly stuff. And you always capture the ones that sounds that you can cling racist thoughts to.
Something.
Yeah. You know? Something. Like, I was thinking about saying, like, you guys are just monkeying around up here.
Right.
And then you, of course, pounced on that.
He has a, why don't you sing a verse from that one song about bananas real quick?
I want to share my banana, share it all with you. I want to share my banana, make this love so true. I want to share my banana.
All right,
banana.
That's great. There you go.
Monkey see, monkey do.
Boom. Monkey see, monkey. I can't believe I almost cut
Is
you off.
Is that an original song?
I almost cut him off before the monkey
so
see, monkey do.
He was writing that song down one night.
Yeah, last episode.
I wanted to hit that line, but that's okay. Yeah, that was fun performing that last week. That was the story about two monkeys named Jacob and Latidra.
All right, my God. Let's get this comedy thing going.
Where's
the, this is enough
racist stuff. That
doesn't
count on that one?
What?
I go, where's the sound?
There we go. I forgot about it.
Maybe we need a better one.
All right, I'll find one.
We need a better accent.
All right.
That's what we'll figure out today.
But I also watched the Willie Hunter show on YouTube. You guys should check this out if you haven't checked on YouTube. It's called the Will Hunter Show. And very good. It was like a Jay Leno with Saturday Night Live or something. I saw Jeremiah. He makes these commercials during the show. It's funny as shit, man. And Tony was even on there. Tony Grinchcliffe, because it was Christmas time.
Yeah, it was for your Christmas special.
Bill Burr was on there, and I was impressed. I mean, it's nice. I mean, I liked the whole intro and the music. I loved it.
I made Bill Burr laugh during that.
Yes.
Thank you.
And that's not easy to do.
Right.
Yeah, you told me you have great respect for him. He's the ultimate.
Who?
Bill Burr.
Yeah.
You told me, and he said he really works hard at it too. It's no chance. It's no luck.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah, it's very.
They
good.
All do. All the best ones do.
Yeah.
My favorite thing about Willie, actually not my favorite thing. That would be rude if I said that way. One of my favorite things about Willie is how he runs. It's one of the best things. It's more of a hop. Like he wants. Like the floor is on fire.
It's very, like, animated.
It's kind of like...
Long strides.
Like, a gallop.
But it's like, do you do that, like, on purpose? Because it's funny as fuck when you do it.
Sometimes I catch myself running and I see people laughing. I was like, well, I think I'm doing this on purpose now. So I keep doing it and people keep laughing. So now I'm like, is this original or is this, like, one of those Dean Del Rey type things, like his voice?
Well, that's
one time Dean Del Rey did an impression of Dean Del Rey to me. It's like, nuts to butts. I was like, wait a minute, this is too much for me.
Dean Del overload.
Yeah.
I recently beat Tinder. I got to the end of it. And
I'm still swiping.
Yeah, and one of the things is the how I beat it, you know, the boss battle and everything. She said she's only been to the Comedy Store once, and there was two people that she said were one of the funniest people she's ever seen, and you were one of them. And I thought that was really cool. That
who said this?
This boss battle girl that I met on Tinder. She's only been to the Comedy Store once.
Some chick he met.
Thank you. My fans.
You're one of the two.
People on Tinder.
There you go.
Oh, I was just going to say, I thought that was interesting. You know, I meet somebody and she's, you know, pointed you out.
I went to all the millions
of comics that are here.
Sometimes it's weird. You're like, you'd be surprised who knows you just randomly at places. You know, and sometimes they try to say encouraging things, but it just hurts. Like, I did La Jolla this past weekend and some guy came up to me who was drunk and he was like, man, I remember seeing you here 2 years ago. I was like, oh, thanks. Leaps and bounds, man. Leaps and bounds.
I know, right? So true.
Thank you, I guess.
In La Jolla especially. It's such a funny call. La Jolla, you really get these people that think they know everything, you know what I mean? And it's their big night in comedy. So they want to share, and it's great, by the way. It's beautiful. Because sometimes it's the most amazing compliment you've ever gotten in your life. But that's rare. On the numbers, because it almost always has a One thing that I've noticed is that I can't stand getting a compliment and then they say somebody else on the show they didn't like. First of all, that's just negative. I don't want to hear about them not liking somebody else.
But, I kind
of
want to know,
but the worst part is when you think that person's funny and they didn't like that person and they just complimented you, and all of a sudden that compliment means nothing to you. So you're like, well, you're a dumb fucking idiot because that person's not even funny at all.
Well, I got one that can beat that. When someone comes up, say me and you perform, and then like this girl comes up and just goes up to you and is like, you are so funny,
right?
And then walk away.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm like, what about me?
Oh, yeah. Or where they go, hey, can you take the picture?
That's always my role, the picture guy.
Heck yeah.
All right.
Well, you know what goes on here. One of the reasons why Willie is was booked for this, why I'm so excited to have him here, is because he hosts the hardcore, the one and the only, the true open mic of LA comedy. That's the open mic here at the Comedy Store every Sunday and Monday. It's been going on for like 30-some years. It's a tradition of huge, huge reputation and magnitude. David Letterman got his original work from hosting that show, and Carson coming in and seeing him host. And since then, all the people that have really gotten that treatment and have marinated in that for years, like Willie has, he's notorious as the host here, it's always a launching pad. Chelsea Handler did it for a long time. Some of the funniest people that we know, you know, the Ari Shaffirs, the Steve Ranazzisis, the Kevin Christies. It's a huge part of being in
touch. Bob Saget?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of them. Jim Carrey?
Michael Keaton?
That's a big one. And I heard he was a great host.
Argus Hamilton?
That's a big one.
Okay, no Argus fans out there.
So his input is he sees a lot of comedy, and at that open mic, you know, every 3 minutes he's up and down off the stage having to keep a show afloat, and who knows if the person did great or bad. Anyway, he sees a lot of it, and he's used to keeping a sinking ship from falling, so I think he's going to fit into this format perfectly, where we draw comedians out of a bucket. They do 1 minute of perhaps new material, perhaps old material that they might want punched up or something like that.
This is how you intro all the shows?
Sometimes it's different. it's one last stabilizing thing before we just lose into debauchery for an hour and 15 minutes or so. So this is their last hurrah.
I'm excited. Is this like a Royal Rumble or something?
It is. It's always exciting. It's always fun. Sometimes the Patriot has input.
Yes. I like to comment on the comedians. I'm a big fan of comedy. You know, sometimes I might have something in common with you, Willie, because sometimes people have race confusion when it comes to me. They think I'm black when I'm really white. Has anybody ever thought you were white when they heard you or something?
Yeehaw!
That's it.
Yeehaw!
Accidental racism.
What up?
Jesus.
No, I don't know. I mean, just if they heard you on a podcast or something.
It has happened once.
Okay, good. Thanks for
I was trying to get a bartender job at a Japanese steakhouse when I lived in Alabama. And I called up and I said, hey, you know, here inquiring about the job. And the guy's like, yeah, come on down, you know. So I go on down and I was like, hey, I'm here for the position. And he looked at me and goes, like, position filled. So he thought I was a white guy over the phone, and then I got there, he's like, no.
Yeah, we have something in common now.
Sure.
Because on Kill Tony 8, this Teddy Ray comedian, he thought I was black. On Kill Tony 8.
Well, yeah, but you're wearing a suit, man. Yeah. A suit of armor that covers everything.
Yeah, but I got a lot of soul, too. They think I'm like one of the Soul Brothers.
This is unacceptable behavior.
That's the one.
What is that?
That's the one.
That might be the new sound effect.
What's funny is that like I'm using this program that's the sound program, and they have like little pictures for each sound, and the picture is actually a black guy. For some reason.
Oh yeah, it is.
That's weird.
Well, right. Here we go. Everybody gets 60 seconds. I'm going to pull our first name out of the bucket. Sometimes we just talk to them about life.
And by the way, you get 1 minute, and you'll hear the one-minute charm, which is, and if you go over that 1 minute and you keep on going, you'll get the West Hollywood Bear.
And if you get that bear, you're in big fucking trouble.
Did you get banned from the club?
The first person coming on stage tonight is Daria Lauren. No. Cause we gonna
go all night till we see the sunlight. Oh, wow. And this.
Well, it's good that that happened. You know what that sound means. She just got blacklisted from the show for life.
And Bobby Lee says
for life?
For life. That's Bobby Lee.
And they're banned from the Comedy Store for 4 months.
Man, you guys should show up for this thing.
Your first comedian tonight is Lil Bro. Here he comes.
I just realized, man, being out in L.A., that there are no gay men out in L.A. Just men that just gave up from trying to get laid. You know, it's like, it's so hard to get laid out here by a woman. They just give up and just, hey, man, you want to sleep with me? Fuck it. Let's do it. You know, I'm thinking like, when they think they're not gay, like, you may not be gay, but the dude sucking your dick is. Like, you might not be gay, but the dude sucking your dick, he definitely gay as hell.
Lil Bro, I've seen you here a couple times. I've gotten to know you over the last... You've been out here how long now? Just like a couple months?
Yeah, like 4 months.
Yeah. Very, very funny. We always make fun of each other in like the parking lot. We go off on these... what do we call that? What's it called again?
Bagging.
Bagging, that's right. That's how cool I am, is that I forgot the name of it. But yeah, so I'm a little bit biased towards thinking you're hilarious anyway. But...
Thanks.
Well, you know, anyway, I like your shirt. There you go.
How long have you been doing comedy?
21 years.
21 years?
Yeah. That was just something I wrote, though.
Right.
That
was
just something. Wait a minute, you've been doing comedy for 21 years?
Yeah, I started in 92.
Wow.
In Houston.
Yeah. Consistently for 21 years?
21 years, never took a break.
Really?
So you used to hang out at the Laugh Stop.
I won Houston's Funniest at the Laugh Stop. I used to be a regular up there at the Laugh Stop. And the Comedy Showcase and the Laugh Spot. Yeah, I've done some touring.
The Laugh Stop was probably one of the best comedy clubs, in my opinion, in the world. And then they closed down, and they took all the tables and all the chairs and everything to this other place and put it exactly like how it was. So you walked in, and you're like, wait a second. This is not the same. It was a trip, man. Yeah.
They moved from Allen Parkway to Walk.
Right.
Yeah, I was there when it was upstairs on Walk, too.
Yeah.
I used to do some nights up there.
21 years. So is that's mostly out of Houston and on the road, or mostly out of Houston?
No, mostly on the road.
Right.
Like, I would tour, but, you know.
Like, you just opened up for Earthquake, right?
Quake, Chappelle. I was on the Block Party tour with Dave Chappelle, Doug Stanhope.
Wow.
Felipe Esparza, before he blew up, me and Felipe was real cool. Like, I know a lot of cats.
It's awesome.
You're a funny dude, Lil Bro. What do you want to do now? Like, how much material have you compiled?
I've actually done 2 hours at the Laugh Stop. I have it on video.
Wow. So two different hours.
No, 2 hours straight.
Oh, one two-hour set.
Yeah.
Wow.
I have it on DVD.
Holy shit.
That's crazy.
Well, if any big producers are listening out there, buy Lil Bro's 2-hour special and then sell it on Netflix.
That's like a motion picture, you know. That's like
that's
like Jurassic Park.
Right.
But with Lil Bro.
And who wouldn't love? I'm sure. Iron Patriot, wouldn't you love it if Lil Bro was in Jurassic Park?
I want to say something about him.
No, don't say it. Don't say it. Don't say it. Don't say it. Don't say it.
You think it's dangerous for a black guy to do gay jokes because they're kind of known for being homophobic a little bit?
Well, that's a great question right there.
The racist is worried about me being homophobic. What the hell?
This is unacceptable behavior.
Oh,
I mean, I know anything goes. I'm just saying. I mean, you just kind of flirt with
them. I love how he tries to rationalize everything in the end, but not, but in no real way. It just trickles into nothingness. You know, I'm just trying to, anyway. Come what, that
well, like, what so you're trying to ask him, like, what's the point of the joke?
No, I was just asking Tony if he thinks that's dangerous, because no. A lot of black guys are already kind of homophobic, and when he's talking that way, it might rub some of the people in the crowd wrong. Not me.
Hey, it makes it relatable for me.
What?
It's relatable now.
Oh, okay.
And, I'm not homophobic, but I don't like gay guys that's all aggressive, you know, while you stand in line. Hey, man, hey.
Yeah. Yeah. I know what you're saying. I know. What
yeah,
you're saying.
You dig it.
I mean, I don't think you're that way. I'm just saying if it might rub some people in the crowd wrong.
No. I have a gay cousin, so it's okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, that I love how quickly the Patriot dismissed it. Well, oh, okay, gay cousin. All right. Well, fuck yeah. That's Lil Bro, everybody. Are you
Thank
on
you.
Twitter or something?
Yeah, at Lil Bro. LILBROUGH.
Wow, like, you spell Bro the hardest way possible.
It's my last name.
Oh, I
yeah,
see.
Yeah, my dad is Big Bro, and I'm Lil Bro.
Oh, I got
yeah.
Any shout-outs you want to give?
Nah.
There he is, everybody. Lil Thank Bro, you, everyone. It's interesting to start off with a guy that's been doing it 21 years. That's a first.
Yeah.
That's different.
You know, interesting thing about that comedy club, opening weekend, I was there for a show with somebody else, and me and this girl I met in the audience fucked on the couch in the green room, and she left the spot there.
Jesus.
And then we came back like 6 months ago and was still there.
Whoa.
That's gross.
Your next comedian, everybody, is Kyle Everett. Kyle Everett, are you here? Well, then you're blacklisted. There you go. That's when you know somebody's been blacklisted.
Do you remember all these people? You write them down?
Yeah, they go in a separate pile. Right next to ranch dressing for some reason. I don't know why that's there.
Oh, that's not ranch.
And I can't stop staring at it is the weird part, this little spot of ranch dressing. Oh, no. I know. Red Band loves turning into a 7-year-old sometimes. No! Oh, my God! Oh, that better have been your ranch, bro. Ari Manis, everybody. Funny rising young talent.
Oh
my
R.
God. Oh no.
R.
Hit it, Patriot. Oh. Poor Ari. He's been working on this great bit that. All right, what are you, his manager?
That seems like a good idea.
I got him booked for the rest of the night. He's a meltdown. Then after that, he's going to the tea leaf. Anyway. This voice in the darkness, his biggest fan.
He's in like that dark corner over there.
He took the two bust of... All right. Put your hands together for Andrew Clements. Da-da-da. You gotta be shitting me.
Wow.
This room is jam fucking packed. That's awesome. Hit it, Patriot.
Man.
What's great is when this fucking thing like really blows up like out of proportion, and these people are like, hey, man, so what's up with the whole blacklist thing? And I'm like, you're done for life, dude. And this is on like 5 nights a week. Right. Anyway. Omid Singh, everyone. I have high hopes. Oh, yeah. Indians are always here.
Thank you. I just went to a dry wedding. I think a dry wedding says a lot about the bride and groom. Mostly, it says that they don't give a fuck about you. Thank you. I'm dating right now. The only thing I miss about being single is fucking other women. Thank you. The inventor of Ritalin admitted on his deathbed that he made up ADD. I would have kept reading, but I got distracted. Thank you. Finally, I want to bring back shows from the 80s that haven't been around for a while and just do a couple tweaks to them. I want to bring back the show Knight Rider and take out all of the car's dialogue. So it just looks like a schizophrenic David Hasselhoff talking to his car. Thank you.
That's awesome.
Omid. Fuck yeah.
Omid.
That's hilarious. Omid? Omid Singh. Fuck yeah. How long have you been doing stand-up?
6 years.
Wow.
That was hilarious, man.
Yeah. Meat is very funny. He does the Comedy Store open mic a lot, headlines that show, and he always does very...
Six years in L.A.?
No, 4 in New York and 2 here.
Yeah. How fun.
That's great.
You know you don't need that paper. Is it just kind of like a crutch? It kind of helps you feel more safe because you got it there in case. But
Jesus Christ. Busting balls over there.
That's what he does. He's a mind fuck.
Well, I mean, he's good. I mean, I'm just thinking. I mean, I don't think he needs it. I think he just, it's like a security blanket.
Do you need the suit?
Or? Oh, jeez. Hey, guys, take it easy. Take it easy. Oh, my God.
Yeah, you're right. People have been suggesting that I get up and do a minute, but... You know, I think that's better time for you guys to use.
There you go. Great answer there. Great answer.
I already get enough time to talk. I'm doing comedy all night. I'm more good at conversational comedy. I don't know if I'm good at this type of shit where you stand up there for a minute.
Fuck. I love how he just pushes his microphone farther and farther back as he gets excited through the show. Yeah, man, that's funny as fuck. The, that Knight Rider one is unbelievable.
Yeah.
I mean, that's almost...
I almost want to edit...
That's almost an empire.
I almost want to go home tonight and edit all the shit out of the episode just to see what it looks like.
Just tag me on it.
Yeah. No, I mean, I'm not going to really do it, but that's how cool the idea is.
I would say that's something you should do. Make that video. Yeah.
Absolutely.
That would be funny, like a little video of that.
It's funny as a joke, but the reason why is because it's funny.
Visualizing it, seeing it, you know.
Right. And so the whole marketing thing would be, it would be something that I feel like would get big on the internet because the word of mouth of that, if the video's cut together properly... The word of mouth works because they laugh when they hear it. Hey, this video I watched, man, of, you know.
Yeah.
Do you have like more? All right. I mean, have you done more examples? Because that's just a good idea, a good formula. Anyway, like Three's Company and Ed Out the Girls, so it's just him and Larry creeping out with some old guy.
The other example was to take Disney characters and take out the Disney character and put the person who's doing the voice. So it'd be like, oh, Gilbert Godfrey.
Right.
It's not as good as the Knight Rider.
No.
Right. Okay, let's keep it moving. Nice. And he's at Brownman 3000. If anybody wants to send him a tag via Twitter,
yeah,
at Brownman 3000.
That's his Twitter name?
Yeah.
Oh,
he went for it.
I'm sorry, it was taken already.
Yeah.
Are you a brown man?
Well, he wanted to be Brownman 3001, but that was
what is like the Price is Right?
Yeah. I've seen this guy before. Put your hands together for Brad Sachs, everyone. Here he is.
O-H-I-O. Thank you, guys. I recently got engaged. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Get married in a year. 1 year. I said to my fiance, hey, before we get married, can we make a sex tape? And she was like, wait, have you seen my sex tape? I was like, no. Can we make a sex tape? She was like, absolutely. Who's going to play you? Yeah, like she's casting my sex tape. Like, bring in the next Richard Simmons-looking motherfucker. Thank you, guys. That's all I got. That's the bit.
Do you remember Mr. Body?
Mr.
No.
Body.
From the 70s? Good Body. Mr. Good Body.
No.
Oh, Google him. He would be a great Mr. Good Body. It's where this guy wore this outfit that you could see like all his muscles or something like that. And he used to be really big in the late 70s, early 80s. And
never heard
of him. He'd just hang out with kids and it's weird.
Sounds great. Yeah. No.
Are you really getting married?
Yes, I am.
When's your wedding?
Next August.
Next August.
Yeah, 1 year.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did you actually ask her if she wanted to make a sex tape?
I didn't know.
Were you thinking?
Total bullshit.
Were you thinking about it?
No.
Did you hide the camera and just not tell her?
No.
Do you think about that?
I was kind of afraid because I know I would probably come in like 2 seconds and then I would just have to put it on loop, so.
Heck yeah.
Yeah.
It makes good Vine video.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would be a great Vine. I'm going to use that.
There you go.
That's good.
There you go.
Yeah.
You can release your sex tape on Vine.
On Vine.
That's it.
There you go. See?
I actually already do that on stage. Sorry.
Really?
Do you do that?
Yeah.
All right.
Boom. How about that for the ultimate sorry. Twist? Hey, here's one you can do. I already do it.
You also kind of look like Art Garfunkel.
Thank you.
Can you sing? Can you sing Bridge Over Troubled Water just a little bit?
Have you ever heard of The Greatest American Hero?
Yeah, people tell me that. I've heard that one. Not that many people know him. And
yeah.
You do have an interesting look. I don't know exactly what it is. It's like the guy from Ghostbusters 2 that talks to the painting.
Oh.
A little.
Viggo!
Yeah.
I will do what you tell me, Viggo!
So, if he was a Jew, I guess. He is a Jew.
Yeah, he is a Jew.
There you go.
Jesus. Who is that, Jew man back there?
That's Jewipedia right there.
Oh, it is Jew man.
That's our autistic movie expert, Joshua Meyerowitz, everybody. Put your hands together for Josh. He is Jewish. He's Jewish. Talking about he is Jewish. Like movies needed one more name dropped for another good Jew in it. Actually, he's Jewish too. Even the bad ones are Jewish. There's a lot of Jewish people in movies. Are you Jewish?
Yes, I am.
100%?
Yeah. Yeah.
Is your fiance?
She is.
Oh,
she's keeping it pure.
It wasn't a big deal to me, though. I would have.
How long have you guys been together?
A couple years. It got serious a couple. We've known each other about 4 years, and then probably got serious, I'd say, like 2 years ago. And here we are. Getting married, getting engaged. Yeah.
Aww.
Thank you.
Is that her
nice.
In the back?
No, she's not here.
What are you most excited about this upcoming like unit union?
That's a good question. You know, it's sort of a load off my mind now. You know, like I've sort of turned that off as far as going out to find, you know, trolling for women and all. Yeah, that's over.
And by the way you look, you would literally be trolling.
Not that, for women, yeah, just trolling.
That's too much.
That's a troll.
That's bullshit.
He would be trolling.
There is something very trolly about you.
Thank you, Tony. I appreciate that.
And you also have a look that says both, like, porn star and Game of Thrones at the same time.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You could release a porno just called Winter is Coming.
It's. I'm going to use that.
Actually, I already say that.
You said that.
I wrote it this weekend. I did it on Saturday night for first time. Sorry, guys.
Yeah, we're not doing anything but doing our material.
I know. That's the first time that's ever happened. Brad.
Well, thank you.
Keep rocking and rolling.
Thank
Good
you,
luck
thank
on
you.
Your wedding.
Thank
Luckily, you.
You
have a year. Be careful.
Yeah. I have 11 months to get out of it, basically. Yeah.
Right. Don't make a baby. Pull out.
She wants a kid bad.
Oh no.
Because she's a little bit older. She's like, let's just get this going right away. So.
She's a little bit older.
How old is she?
She's
74?
She's 39.
39.
Oh, she really wants a baby.
She wants it like now. Oh, yeah. She's like, just put it in, just shoot it right inside me. Just do not pull out ever.
Oh my God.
You should talk about that.
Yeah, definitely. What's your strategy for that?
I mean, do.
How do you avoid not having a baby?
I'm ready. I said, fuck it. Because I'm 39 too.
Oh.
So I like kids. You know, I figure if I don't do it now, then maybe.
You're 39?
39.
Wait.
Wow.
And you're from Ohio, right?
I went to Ohio State, but I grew up in New Jersey.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's great.
That was close. Yeah. Probably graduate in 93?
I graduate high school?
Yeah.
92.
92.
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah. She wants a kid so bad, she's got an app on her iPhone that took our pictures and morphs them together and spits out a picture of what the kid will look like.
I was 6 years old.
Yeah.
I know, man. That's
I feel old as fuck when I hang out here. I'm like,
it's so hard for me. One thing I'm learning as I grow up is that it's hard to play it cool when you're like when you're, say for example, 29, and you hear, are you just walking away and assuming that this is going to be a huge insult?
I don't want to take everyone's time. You know, I'm
You're fine.
You know, all right.
Just Stay in the pocket, Brad. Don't freak out now.
No. I don't want everyone to be like, hey.
Remember, there's a lot of people already blacklisted.
That's true.
Willie, right. And that's just the list of blacks that the Iron Patriot doesn't like.
All right, now, see what I mean? I always set him up for those jokes. God.
You guys realize I'm 39 also. You're making me feel bad.
Well, actually, I did want to get back to it. I'm glad you segued me back into that thing, because I'm finding it harder as I, like, right now I'm 29. Okay, you guys are 39. Willie, how old are you?
I turn 27 next week.
Wow. God. As a girl, you'd be too old for me.
It's, yeah, Willie's a cougar at this point.
Right.
But I find it so hard to play it cool, like when somebody says 39, like I just want to be like, oh, God.
Ooh.
But I can't do that, you know, or else I'm a dickhead.
I just do it.
Yeah, I'm sorry that it hurts your feelings.
They know how old they are.
By the way, there's going to be, I'm going to be 39 eventually, hopefully. I'm gambling on the fact that all these surgeon generals are wrong about the cigarettes that I smoke packs of a day. And hopefully they're wrong, and I'm going to make it to 39, and there's going to be some shit-talking little punk.
Make it to 39?
Yeah, you're going to be talking shit about me being 50.
Oh, yeah, that's pretty crazy.
It continues.
Oh, my God. That was Brad Sachs, by the way. He's at Brad Sachs on Twitter, talking about my fiance. That's Brad Sachs, S-A-C-H-S. Interesting last name. Put your hands together for Michael Lenoci.
Hey, what's up, guys? My girlfriend, she dumped me, and then right after she dumped me, a few weeks later, she started dating a professional football player. So after I found out, I went home and I deleted him off Madden. Fuck you, bro. You could have her, but you won't be a part of my franchise. I've won like 5 Super Bowls in a row. I was at my commercial agent's office, and we filled out this survey where you had to like rate yourself 1 to 4 in areas that you're really good in, like stand-up, improv. And then there's questions on there like hula hooping. Like, who the fuck's like, I'm a level 4 hula hooper. Like, that's so stupid. Then there's one on there that's called fire eating. I'm pretty sure with fire eating, you're either a 4 or you're dead. There's no in-between with fire eating. Like, there's no one walking around with half their face missing. Like, what the fuck's wrong with that guy? Oh, he's a level 1 fire eater. Okay. All right, guys. That's my time.
Fuck yeah. Michael Lenoci.
Wow. Perfect minute.
Yeah. Nailed it, right?
Yep.
59? Oh, wow. 1:02.
I've been practicing all week. You know?
Wow.
I'm just like, let's get this perfect.
What was the first joke again?
Madden joke.
Oh, yeah.
That's funny.
Yeah,
because
there's definitely more to that. That's definitely tag worthy.
I just met somebody that their ex is a really famous professional football player. So I'm kind of like in a backwards version of that right now. Like, I'm thinking like the ex-boyfriend is like a guy that he's actually, right. I think, 320 pounds. And he's like 7 feet tall. I mean, it's imagine having. So there's a lot of material you could write about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I kind of want you to keep going with that scenario.
Yeah.
You know, like you delete him off Madden, like he's still fucking your girl.
Right.
So you still lose at the end.
Yeah.
Like I was hoping like go to that route, you know?
Right. That, I mean, there's so many places.
Like finish
you
the
can
story,
go.
You know?
Right. And, you know, she left you. Okay, I gotcha. Yeah, you know what might be great? This is weird. Now there's way too much setup. Forget it. No, it's like maybe there's something in the fact that you hope that they make a baby because with his physical genetics and her, that's how close I am to the tag.
The only thing I was thinking
is
how horrible it would be if I forgot to delete him off Madden and I was playing one day and he like intercepted me or something. Like I feel like that.
Oh yeah, that's
that
great.
Would be worse. Like I don't. You, fine, you fucked her, but like to now intercept me too. Like that's rubbing it in my face.
Right.
I've played with it, but I don't know. I gotta.
Well, that part should definitely be somewhere mixed in there.
Or you play as him, and you make him just a complete idiot. Like, just make him go in circles and stuff like that, throwing the ball and hitting referees and stuff.
Right. Change his position to a kicker.
I changed all his attributes. Horrible.
Yeah, that's fun. And then the second joke was about
the questionnaire. Remember, he went to the. He was. You're gonna be working on advertisements and commercials, and there was a question about a hula hoop.
Yeah, I remember because I wrote it. So yeah.
That reminded me of when I went to Central Casting. I had to fill out one of those things, and you know they ask you if you'll get naked or you know and different weird questions. And
did you say yes?
No.
Why wouldn't you get naked on film?
Well, I'm scared my banana might just shoot right up in the air. Oh. It'd be embarrassing.
Do you trim down there?
Do I what?
Do you trim down there?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I trim it. I keep it looking good.
Awesome.
Hey, did you notice, I read them, just a side note, did you notice they just upheld the court decision that they got to continue wearing rubbers in porn films?
Yeah.
So they tried to fight it. They have to keep that peel on the banana.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I personally
this whole banana reference with your dick is so creepy. Oh my God. Not as creepy as that laugh though.
No, don't call me creepy. I hate when people call me creepy.
Oh my God.
You won't like it when I'm
creepy.
Oh
man. I think we just learned a lot about what he looks like under that suit.
Come on, I'm a good looking guy.
I hate it when people call me creepy.
Come on, man. America needs me right now. Don't be putting me down like that.
He's a level 4 creepy right there.
Oh, shit. Yeah, how long have you been doing stand-up, Michael?
3 years next month.
Wow. Where are you from?
South Florida.
Oof.
Eek.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did you start there?
No.
You started here?
Yeah.
Wow. Well, cool, man. Well, keep rocking. That's funny stuff. Definitely extend that Madden stuff. Man.
Yeah.
You got a whole thing there.
And I really like the hula hoop fire thing. It was good, too.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah. And then there's probably more on top of it. You know, there's so much you could do with that. A football player. You know, fucking, I don't know. Put your hands together for Carlos De Jesus, everybody. Carlos is an employee.
I love that music.
What's up, guys? I miss hanging out with Asian people. I do. I used to have a lot of Asian friends. Then I stopped breakdancing. And they all went away after that. It's crazy. I work here at the Comedy Store. I'm a bouncer for some reason. I don't know why they chose me to do this job. Sometimes they make us work, and I'm not a big fan of that. The other night, we had an urban show. It was a Tuesday. And basically what that is, it's a black show. All right? So there was this one white guy in the audience, and he's there with a black woman. And so the host goes around. He's like, hey, how long have you been with a black woman for? The white guy responds, what's your problem, N-word? Yeah, completely fucking tense. Completely tense. Everybody's looking at me in the room like, you should go do something before, like, anything happens. And I'm thinking, like, I'm not going to run down there and get my ass kicked alongside with him. You know, I didn't say shit. It's not my fault. My whole move was just to record it, upload it to World Star Hip Hop, and then leave. That's all I was going to do. That's my joke, guys.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bless you. God bless you. Well, what are you allergic to over there?
I think I got allergies all
of a sudden.
Fuck yeah.
That's strange. No, her allergies just now.
Fuck yeah. So you told it like a, that was like a, that was probably like a true story.
Yeah.
Yeah, you said it like a rant. Like,
Everybody wants to know, everybody's going to want to know what ends up happening after that. Like, the fact that your goal is to put it on World Star Hip Hop sounds like the setup to a bigger joke. Does that make sense?
It does make sense.
What happened after that?
Well, basically, he saw
The guy who said the N-word puts on an Iron Patriot suit and walks away.
That's the joke.
Well, I mean, we need the Iron Patriot to get a little bit more famous before it works on stage.
Or just show up to all of his shows.
Right.
I see what you're saying.
So what did happen after he said that?
Well, basically, like, because the guy has been with this woman for 10 years. So when Esau was talking to her, Like, he saw that, like, this guy isn't really racist. He was just saying some shit to, like, kind of, like, stir it up, get along with them. I don't know why you would do that. But, like, that, it was like that. And so he just basically deterred it before anything happened. That's all that happened.
So nothing happened.
No, yeah, nothing.
Everybody was laughing because he saw was killing it.
It was tense. Nobody was laughing. It was just kind of like nothing happened. Nobody got their ass kicked that night.
Right.
It would have been me, too.
Was it like a little white guy or a big white guy?
It was like skinny, probably about 6 foot tall German guy.
How skinny? Like really
like
skinny?
Your size. Like your size.
Like my size skinny? Man, that guy's got a huge set of balls.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a huge set of balls.
Yeah.
My size skinny.
Yeah.
Dropping the N-word at an urban show?
Yeah, I know. I didn't know what to do either. I was like, what the fuck?
Right.
I love how
you have to immediately assume that this guy has a weapon on him of some kind.
Exactly. Oh, I'm surprised shit can go down.
Man. I just love how you call it an urban show. I never said that.
That is a very inside-the-business type of terminology. Yeah. They call it an urban show.
What would you
show.
Call it besides that?
Yeah, Iron Patriot. What would you call it?
I don't know. I knew what he was talking about when he said that.
No, but what would you, if you had to use another word for urban, what would you choose?
Yeah.
The Harlem Globetrotters.
I don't think you understood the question.
Yeah. That was...
What would be if you, let's say you're a thesaurus, okay? And black and urban are already taken. What would be your next descriptive word?
Roots the next generation.
Oh my gosh.
This is unacceptable behavior. This is unacceptable behavior.
Oh my god.
Uh-oh.
Wow. That's amazing.
The saddest part is that's pretty good.
Yeah.
Can't do anything about it. Just hope that no one calls me that.
What would you have done if you've been working the door and you heard, you know, I mean, obviously you wait and you.
I would have escalated.
Get him!
Oh, yeah.
And I stay in the back.
That's a great way to go.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Right. Just, you join the group. That's what I always do.
Yeah, but I would have been the only light-colored guy in there besides.
But you'd have been down for the cause.
Yeah, I mean,
there you
I
go.
Just don't want to get my ass kicked.
Yeah, because you joined the people. Have you ever been part of a stomp out?
Yeah, they're great.
They're awesome when you're the person throwing kicks in.
That's true. That's true. I'd be the last one in.
Yeah, no one goes to break up a stomp out. You join a stomp out.
That's true. That's very true. That's very true.
And that's what I would do in that situation.
Fuck yeah.
I would just yell out, get him!
Take all that shit and turn it into something with that whole thing and that whole story. That's Carlos De Jesus. You on Twitter? Oh, he doesn't have Twitter, everybody. There you go. Put your hands together for Tommy Lee, everyone. I know Tommy Lee.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, okay. I hate getting called a creep, too, man. It's terrible. The worst, dude. It sucks. I mean, I got called a creep the other day, like, for no reason. Like, it's like I bump into you, and you just spill your drink all over me, and, like, I'm the creep somehow. Like, it's the worst thing ever, because, like, as a guy, getting called a creep is, like, the C word, right? It's, like, offensive, because, like, your night is over after that, right? Because every woman just agrees with that woman that you're a creep for the rest of the night, and they just validate what she said to you, and they're just like, yeah, I bet he touches kids, too. Yeah. Oh, those are child molester shoes right there. Yeah. Oh my God. Like, what the fuck are child molester shoes? It's like, what did I do? I'm just standing here. That's it, guys. Thank you.
Yeah, those aren't child molester shoes.
Because you have the same pair on?
No.
Oh.
Wait a second here. Let me see if I got my child molester
they're
shoes on.
They're a little
on.
Bit more.
I think I got child molester socks on.
Oh, yeah, you do. Holy shit. You boys like...
lemonade?
Let's talk about that shirt for a moment, shall we?
The child molester shirt?
Yeah. Like, did your dad give that to you?
No, I bought it. Actually, my mom got it for me.
There you go.
Yeah.
I like it. Yeah. So what?
Have you been called creepy before?
Yeah.
Jeez. I'll take that as a yes. Exploded from your spinal cord.
I feel like it's happened to like a lot of guys for like no reason, you know?
It never happened to me.
No, it really doesn't.
And never. I know when I'm over getting towards that threshold of being creepy. I don't think you know.
I think it happens to you and Foot Fetish McRacist next year over there. I have a great question. Patriot, do you have a yellow dress shirt like this hanging up in your closet for when you're not in the suit?
I have a shirt similar to that.
What do you...
I probably iron it better when I take it out, though.
Oh! Damn.
No, he didn't.
You just got burned from the Patriot. Know, he doesn't even have any weapons. Oh, that's great. I love that sound.
The burn sound?
You just got burned. I love sound effects.
I know, they're stupid.
They make me so happy. Fuck, Tommy, what did you talk about?
How can you critique something you don't remember?
Oh, yeah, the...
Did you write that just now?
Creep.
No.
Okay. That was weird that you used the creepy thing. That's a good callback.
You say the word creep so many times in the bit that I'm wondering if you're sponsored by, like, TLC or something. are you trying to bring that song back? Is this, like, subliminal marketing?
No.
How often would you say, if you had to guess, per month, does somebody call you a creep?
Oh, it's not like a regular thing. It's happened before, and it sucks.
Did it happen one time when somebody spilled coffee on you? Or
no, I was at a bar, and I was waiting in line for the bathroom, and a girl bumped into me and spilled a drink on me, and she got mad and called me a creep.
Oh.
For no reason. Just
what'd you call her?
I was like, I'm sorry.
Did you?
So funny.
Did you apologize before or after she called you a creep?
I think after, because I was like, I thought I did something wrong, but I didn't. You know, I don't know why. I just said I'm sorry.
Wow, aww. You're such a pussy.
Yeah. I know.
My response would have been, I'm not a creep. You're a fucking dumbass. You just spilled your drink on me. You dumb. Piece of shit, lady.
Lady, clean it up at the end. Lady. Cunt bitch, lady.
Lady. Oh.
Fuck yeah. I would lose that shirt, bro.
Okay.
I really would. This is a part of the show I like to call lose that shirt.
I think everyone's mom says you look good in yellow, but that doesn't mean you should wear it.
Right.
Okay.
It's all right. You just don't wear the shirt.
Yeah. Save it for Easter or something.
I like pastels.
It is an Easter shirt, isn't it?
Yeah.
Thanks.
He's a Tommy Lee comedy on Twitter. That's Tommy Lee.
I think something we've learned from this show is the way you dress is just as important as your jokes. Because remember that guy that had the hole in his pants and stuff?
It definitely works for you.
Yeah, if you look very tight, like if you have like your, you know, like you're dressed up for church,
yeah,
you're going to give out kind of a vibe of that's, you know, while you're on stage.
That's definitely a church look, which is also can be filed under pedophile. Yeah. Church and pedophile go hand in hand, so it sort of went full circle there. So yeah. There you go. Next comedian is Eddie Mauldin, everybody. It's Eddie Mauldin as we move forward. Oh, he's coming from deep in the gullet. Look what happened.
All right. Hey, guys. How's it going? If I shiver a little bit, I'm not nervous. I get cold really easily because I am what doctors call a pussy. Gotta stop going to my dad for medical advice, but that's all right. Let's see, what do I want to talk about? A lot of my friends are having kids, which is kind of weird. I'm very young, and I know I'm not ready to have kids. I've got it all planned out, though. I know what I want when I have kids. I want to have three beautiful black daughters. Yeah. Or I may just hire some backup singers. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. One's for you, Iron Man. Getting pretty excited, though. I'm working on a book.
I'm really into photography. It's coming out soon. You guys can look for it. It's going to be called There's Waldo. It's just him hanging out at the beach, chilling. You know. Fantastic. All right, we'll end it on that. Let's do that.
Well, yeah. Whoa. You made the bear come out. It ends on the kitty meow. Nice to meet you, Eddie. How long have you been doing stand-up?
About 3-4 years. Yeah.
From here?
South Florida, and I moved out here about a year ago. Oh. Yeah.
Now, there's a lot of comedy in South Florida.
Yeah,
I guess
it's all happening.
Not really.
A lot of people taking their talents to South Beach.
Yeah, I guess LeBron started something.
Heck yeah.
Yeah. Yep. So.
You a fan of like the Heat?
Not a big Heat fan.
What's your favorite thing about South Florida?
Favorite thing. The racism is. I'm on the right side of the fence, so that's kind of nice.
What side of the fence is that?
White.
Why am I put up here in this situation? Is this like a big joke on me?
This is unacceptable behavior.
Thank you. All right.
Yeah, that's the one. I love that.
Uh-oh. What do
they call that sound, that thundering one?
Thunder.
Oh, it's so great.
Yeah.
fuck yeah. First of all, South Florida is an interesting place. Have you ever been there, Iron Patriot?
I think it's funny how he talked about... No, I haven't been. My mom's been to Florida. She worked with JCPenney, but I haven't been there.
She went with who?
With JCPenney. She used to work with JCPenney. She went for a model.
The JCPenney?
Yeah.
Steve JCPenney? Wow.
Wait a minute. You said model?
My mom.
Oh, went to Florida with JCPenney?
Yeah, she worked for JCPenney, and she went to Florida where there was like a model shoot. She was in charge of the artwork and the photography, the models and stuff like that. But I've never been to Florida. I've always wanted to go.
Was she upset when you worked at Sears?
That is a great question. I can't believe you. That's a great question.
You're hanging out with JCPenney and then your son.
But I wanted to say something. You know what I thought was funny about your joke is you basically said you want your wife to give birth to the Supremes. Stop in the name of love. Okay, before you break my heart.
I could tell he almost didn't commit to that second part.
Halfway through.
Before you break.
Well, that's what the Jackson
Father. Then you had to follow through after he started.
Jackson Five. I mean, that's not too way off. People do that shit.
You know, there's other groups other than just that one group. You know that, right?
Yeah.
That you saying the Supremes actually falls under accidental racism with the Iron Patriot. Hey, it's just like that one group.
Black women, if you
want to.
You could have said TLC maybe or something.
I would probably just lose that joke, by the way.
Yeah, I was going to say that.
That's a pretty bad joke.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. It seems like it's unnecessary.
I'm not saying this as a black man. I'm saying this as a comedian.
Yeah, I think it's just... It's like when you say you want three black kids, it's like, oh, here we go.
A little much.
Yeah, and then when you get to the actual payoff, it's like, that's not even funny. So why even throw that pee in the pool, you know? Like, unless it's fucking awesome, you know, then it backs up even the idea. I don't know.
My thing is, if you're going to be racist.
Right.
Yeah. Some more racist.
Thank you.
But not like, Willie.
Yes.
Not like Kramer, though. Don't go that crazy.
Jesus, isn't that the pot calling the kettle black? Literally.
Pot calling the kettle the N-word.
Oh my God!
All right, that was just
that was a cackle.
It's like a white hate cackle.
Yeah.
Bit of a witch.
Fuck yeah. Yeah, there's something of maybe there's something there. Like if you want three black daughters, that's that you could raise them to be background vocalists or something.
Yeah, I think if I sell it better, a lot of it is on the turn. I'm kind of trying to set up like a real wholesome kind of. Set up and then twist it, so I might have rushed it. I don't know.
It's a racist joke. What are you trying to be wholesome about?
Well, so yeah,
like a racist joke for the kids.
Set up, you know.
I'm sorry.
No, you're right.
I agree with Willie. I think that I just, you know, if you want to try to rewrite it and stuff like that, whatever.
Yeah,
but
I might toss it. You know,
maybe just write a different joke.
But I do like where your head's at, and I know where you're getting, you know, from point A to point B. But maybe it's like a different type of. You know, subjects. You
yeah,
know,
yeah.
Scenarios. Yeah. But I know where you're going. It's a funny premise, but it's just...
Maybe choose Asian. They're easier to pick on.
That's good.
I think you have a, you have a good delivery system. Everything
great
else is
stage
good.
Presence.
You know what I mean? Totally. That seems beyond 3 years. So
no, thank you.
Definitely just keep chipping away at Do you write a lot?
Yeah. I got a lot of those. Were mostly like one liners.
Right.
I have so I got longer bits and more stuff like that. So
how much material? Like if you had to max out and do as much
like good like tested stuff, probably like 20, 25.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
there you go. That's great. He's right on par. 3 years. Yeah. Eddie Mulden, everybody. He's at Eddie Mulden on Twitter. Oh, this is something different. Mogali, everyone. Mogali.
Mowgli.
Oh, this is the super racist guy.
I'm not afraid of racism, ladies.
He said the N-word.
That's true. I have said the N-word. I am from North Miami. I'm not afraid of it. I will say my set is going to start with something different, though, tonight. I'm working on a mega set. I'm going to keep it separate until it's ready.
Oh, my God. He just
said it again. But I will say, I just moved out to L.A. recently from North Miami, and I'm going to be honest with you guys. I don't know the first thing about being Indian. This is true. But I didn't realize there's a lot of Indians that work in background in L.A., and I got picked up for an episode of Arrested Development recently. And I got the set, and they all came up to me, and they're like, oh, my God, it's so nice to meet you. I can't believe it. You're the star of the show today. What is your name? My name's Bunkta Chikadaga Bunkta Chikadaga. I was like, what? I was like, my name's Michael. And they're like, Michael? What did you get a name like Michael? I was like, I was named after Michael Jackson. And they're like, what? Oh my God. Don't you realize you're Indian? I was like, you don't think I know I'm Indian? My mom's got a fucking mustache. I'm like, honestly, if my mom grows out a beard, we look identical. That's ridiculous. All right, thanks a lot.
There you go.
I could tag the shit out of that.
Well, that's that. Next person.
Yeah, I guess so. If you believe that, then I guess you have it all figured out to begin with.
Well, you came back with the same joke as you did last time, but it was, you added that one. I don't remember you doing the mustache part last time.
I didn't
have
time to finish because I ruined it by starting with shit.
Right. It's a very long build-up.
Very, very long.
But a big laugh.
Yeah.
I mean, and it just ends in,
I hate that fake voice.
When it ends at hairiness, I'm just, an Indian hairy joke, we know it's coming. I like the mustache, but I don't know, I'd almost try to find a segue out of that topic as fast as you can, because if you're just going to be another fucking Indian guy talking about body hair for...
Well, what I do is I segue out of that, and I say, I'm not your stereotypical Indian, really, and then I go into some jokes that are just normal.
That are, like, stereotypical.
Do you even think I need it? Because I feel like every now and then I'll do a set, and if I start... Without doing an Indian joke?
I like the line, you don't think I'm a fucking Indian? My mother has a mustache. Like, it seemed like you were passionate about it.
I do like the line.
You
can
almost
just
say that at any point.
You can just say that line.
Right.
Rather than that long setup.
And going through that fake accent part just kind of makes you go, oh, here we go.
Oh, yeah, totally. Right.
Yeah, don't even do the accent ever again. Yeah.
Really?
Ever.
It's not worth it?
And you go back and forth. The only people that are going to chuckle at stereotypical Indian accent are idiots anyway, so.
Oh, my God.
You don't want them to like you.
Nice.
Okay, you know what? I kind of like the accent.
Yeah.
Should I start doing
it? Well, there you go.
Yeah.
It's only funny when white people do it, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah.
Doopy, 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 doopy. Doopy, doopy, doopy.
Oh, I am doopy, doopy, Indian. Doopy, doopy, Indian. That's my... Is that not a... I've never been known for my impressions.
It's very comical the way you did it. Don't try to do it like... Because the accent itself is funny. Don't try to make the accent the whole joke.
Definitely. Because it ain't happening.
Throw that part out.
Yeah.
Like,
I'm
going to
try it without the accent. I've never even tried it without the accent.
That little piece, that one little line, just find a place to throw that in somewhere and just use that one line. That's great. You don't need the whole setup about Arrested Development, meeting somebody. I think you just need that one line.
Yeah.
The one line being...
The mustache.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I mean, because that's the only funny part in that whole story.
True.
So might as well just take that piece out, find somewhere else to throw it in, and then whatever joke you throw it in, it's going to blow that joke up.
But I think, because I've seen him go up before, that this joke is longer than...
It is.
Because the rest of the development part needs to stay in there, but he just needs to clean up. There's so much, nonsense, like Michael Jackson. You throw that out. Yeah. The accent, throw that out. You say, hey, my name is Michael. He's like, don't you know you're Indian? And then you can do that joke, and then you can keep going on throughout the bit. It's just so long,
Yeah.
I think Dion used to say on the set all the time, he's like, that's a long walk for a drink of water.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So would you say, I guess I'm getting a little bit mixed here. So is it worth the setup for the punchline or just cut
a little
bit out?
That's part of the longer joke. You have to keep that setup.
Yeah.
Go ahead and say the rest of the joke.
What's the longer joke is that, you know, it was like an Indian mafia that was working on set. Like these guys, like they came up to me and they were like, oh, we're all from outsourced. And I was like, outsource? You guys from India? They're like, no, it's a different TV show. They brought us over on the set. And I was like, oh, this is cool, you know. But the hardest part was that I haven't really developed it all together
yet.
What's
the punchline of the end of the whole joke?
Oh, well, the end of the whole joke is that I talk about being an Indian goat herder on set. And needless to say, none of them wanted to be my friend for the day. My only friend on set for the rest of the day was a goat. And that's really it.
Ugh.
But you know, it's true. I sat by myself
the beginning
the whole
of the
day.
Joke.
Yeah, so I took that part out, though.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of what would be funny, because, you know, hairy mom jokes are, you know, a dime a dozen. So when you ask whether it's worth it or not, I would say it's worth it. If your mom had a mustache, I would really fucking break that open and talk about different things, like how maybe Indian women are at an advantage if they ever want to, you know, be a tranny or something. Yeah. It's like they already have the mustache. Like, it's like... they already have a pat on the back from God. Like, go head to the other side of... go be a guy for a while.
Oh, this
you know,
is great
something.
Stuff.
Well, yeah, well, luckily, my mom doesn't have that filthy gene that you come from. So I can't do the joke because my mom's not that hairy because she's a fucking American hero.
Oh.
Hey, that's a shout-out to my mom. What's wrong?
Yeah, that's good.
And you're an Indian.
Yeah, true. This is true.
Anyway... good job. There you go.
We had that same discussion when David Taylor was on here and about Sarah. Remember, we had that same discussion about if you want to kill Tony, don't hit all the stereotypes that are just obvious. He's not going to get killed by that.
Oh, that's interesting. I like his knack for branding. If you want to kill Tony.
Yeah.
That's so funny. Well, there you go.
Well,
there
I appreciate
he is.
It. Thanks a lot, guys.
Yep, Mowgli, everybody.
Yeah.
I like how you have
Mowgli.
Your... Mowgli.
At M. Mowgli, M-O-W-G-A-L-I.
Oh, you're making me hate you right now. Go. Get away.
Great.
Googly Mowgli.
I hate it when people go like this with a mic. Like, why would you ever?
Oh, it's Mowgli.
Dookie, dookie.
Do your impression of Mowgli.
Doopity, doopity, Indian doopity.
I'll be laughing about that for weeks.
All right, let's move on to our final segment of the show. Every week we have two regulars that come on, and they've been with us for most of the episodes, and the high majority. I think they've both only missed one, actually, or something like that. But it's always fun. We've been building them here over a long period of time. I believe this is our 12th or 13th week doing this, and so starting off, as always, up first, here since the first episode of Kill Tony, and she's here once again. Put your hands together for Sarah Mostajabi, everyone.
Hi, guys. So I just got my own apartment. That's about as much support as I was expecting. It's been really sad. I've kind of been drinking, like, a lot. Like, I drink at home by myself every night. And it's just kind of like, if I have to get a fucking paper bill for a wireless service, I need to be drunk. Like, I can't handle it. I didn't start drinking until I was about 25, because I didn't like the way that it made me feel. But as I got older, I realized I never liked the way I feel, and I might as well just be drunk the whole time. Every night I get real hammered by myself, and I just think about, you know, the one that's always loved me. I really miss my dog, you guys. It's fucking sad. When I moved in, I saw that there was a pre-K school next door, and I thought, even though my neighborhood's kind of suspect, it would be a little safer, and I was really relaxed. And then I realized yesterday it was a state pre-K.
It was a state pre-K?
Yeah, what the fuck do you have to do to get sent to state pre-K? And then it goes into, like, tags with what preschoolers would have to do to get sent to state.
What would they have to do to get sent to state?
Well, the quickest, and this is just something, I've been working on this bit, like, all week. Like, I've been trying to find something that's funny about that. And what I thought of today was be like, Jimmy's going to be gone from class. He's been sniffing the glue sticks. He's been sent to state. Something. Sorry. I'm trying to be. I've been working on it, so I've been.
What was the joke before the pre-K one?
I did the one about like drinking alone and like thinking about the only one that's ever loved me, and it's like my dog. It's kind of like you think I'm gonna be like, oh, I'm sad about a dude. Nope, it's a bitch.
I guess.
It could be funnier, but that's why I'm.
Well, I mean, it could be less depressing, also.
Yeah, I guess that's what it is.
I don't want it to be depressing. I'm just trying to be like real. So I'm trying to work on making the stuff that I think and feel funny. You know.
You might want to cut out one of the four. I am drinking alone.
The drinking alone. Yeah.
Because you said that for like four times.
Yeah, I don't know. It's fucking me up, man.
Hey, Sarah. What if you get a new dog, put peanut butter on your pouch, and let the dog
What the fuck?
Wow.
That came out of nowhere.
What is happening?
Can I just
him?
Say that your impeccable racism today has been very American patriot. Good job, America. Thank you.
Yeah, that's
the
way to turn the
page. That's
a patriot's world. Everybody else just lives in it.
Whoa, somebody's meds are running off right now.
Malfunctioning happening.
Are you like the Tin Man? Do we need to like oil you so that you're not dysfunctional?
What the fuck?
What?
I think you might just want to keep it at a minute. And now, what else? What was the joke before the?
There was a lot of narration. I thought again, where you there was a lot. I mean, I think it was 30 seconds. I looked over till you got to like a joke, or maybe I missed the joke, but.
You were hard umming too. These are all common things of being new. I mean,
I know. To be honest with you, I get so much more nervous here because I actually care what you guys think than I do at like other like open mics or shows that I do. It's crazy. It's because I did that bit all week long and it's been good, but I'm just a little retarded.
No, don't say that.
No.
No. I mean, I'm working on it. That's why I'm here. No.
Yeah.
Cut some of that fat off. Clearly. Just being
I don't know what that
right.
means either. that's what we do here.
What was the
first thing that you talked about before the depressing dog thing?
That I got. I usually say that I got a new place, and usually like nobody says anything, and I'm like, yeah, that's the kind of support I like. You know, like it's just kind of that's a hot crowd. You know, like kind of recognize that.
Yeah, you don't need to do that either.
Yeah.
Oh.
You want to start off with a boom.
Yeah.
Not a what the fuck?
Well, I get.
Right.
I don't know.
Yeah, you don't want to. That's another thing that's very common early on. And I mean, most people, it takes years before they even realize they do it or before somebody tells them.
I've just seen like higher level people do it, and I would like. I try to.
And those are the people on their way down.
Oh.
Those are the higher level people that. Maybe got too much too fast and sold their soul. And they got credit, so now they have a good spot, but they're never going to maintain it because they're not genuinely good. And they haven't learned through the bad habits of doing things like hard umming and doing things as easy as saying something that won't get a reaction and then making the joke off that.
Right.
I mean, if it's going to hit, it has to be epic, epic, epic.
Right.
Willie, is this your first time seeing Sarah?
She went up last night.
Yeah, I did the open mic yesterday.
Do you remember? Or did you watch it? Or?
You watched. You were there. That face is great. Yeah.
I mean, I was there.
That face says cigarette break. Is I think what happened during.
No, I was I was there. I mean, sometimes I just zone out.
Right.
Thanks. I'll be in the bathroom cutting myself if you need me. So.
We can always count. I believe that's our.
I think that's your set next week, right?
Nine. You love making cutting jokes.
I just think it's fun. I'm sorry.
It's funny?
I think darkness is funny.
Yeah.
I think just being really what I really am.
How do you guys feel about it? The cutting comment.
Are you really dark? Do you still cut?
Why
no,
you
no.
laugh?
I just...
Do you get wet when you see a knife?
You ever go cuts to butts? Okay, well, that's, I really don't know where to, you know, I feel like part of this isn't always us tagging you. I feel like in this part of the show, like, it's like nipping those habits in the butt, you know what I mean? And reinforcing that sometimes is fun. Yeah. I don't really know if, you know, since you're doing a new 60 seconds butt. Every week, whatever.
I mean, what? How do you write? Do you, like, I mean, you, like, try to drown yourself and then just wake up and then...
Did you just get in the bathtub of water?
No. It's just all on a bathroom wall and blood.
And all your writing smeared because of
knock,
the water.
Knock, knock. Who's there?
It's like the butterfly effect.
Right.
You walk into our bathroom.
I write with my
like...
own blood.
All right. Now you just had to take it there, huh?
Oh, Jesus. God. That's not... We're
having fun over here.
I can't ride the train, just you
it's
guys.
It's good
all
to
right.
be dark, but it's still a comedy club, not a funeral home, okay? We're not like here to pay memoriam to that minute of material that you did.
I guess dark, you know, dark can be funny, but how you give it out, we believe that you believe it. So like if you're doing a joke about cutting, we're like, oh my God.
She
instead of like you
herself.
Going, damn these cutters. Ding, ding, ding. You know what I mean? Like
yeah.
like
you have any Yosemite Sam of cutting myself?
Well, if you're going to talk about it, you should definitely do it in a different way instead of making us all go, oh my God.
Okay. Well, right. Eventually my vulnerability won't come off as weakness, you know?
Vulnerability won't come off as weakness.
Are you ticklish?
I will.
No.
I knew
I don't
it.
Feel anything.
God damn it. Hey, right there, that's funny. But
vulnerability always comes across as weakness. Losing the vulnerability, then you don't get weak. So to think people won't perceive your vulnerability, no, that's you have to get rid of that. And that's why people do this for years and years and years. Because it takes that long of reinforcement to be able to work that out. You want to keep that, but lose those jokes. Sarah Mostajabi, everybody. There she goes. Hey, she does, I gotta give her credit. She does a new 60 seconds every week. It's not always gonna be pretty. Yeah. This is a real fucking thing. Yeah. Have you guys wanna judge? Have you ever seen somebody do new 60 seconds? This is all new. It's like a historical moment.
Started, ever since like the third day.
Yeah, she's exploring new territory every
of
week.
Of course, totally.
But
it's
I think
always,
maybe one time
it's always different. It's amazing. Josh Martin's done this show twice and he did the same 60 seconds both times.
What a faggot.
Yes, of course, but you're not on a mic right now.
Judge Martin has a nice chest.
Did you have a question? What about Tig?
No, I just, I just meant that somebody who's, like, takes a really dark, bad, weird experience in her life.
And writes her ass off
I know,
she has an amazing joke.
That's what I'm doing, man. I'm in it for 10 years or however long.
I love it. I love it. Yeah. There she goes again. Sarah Mostajabi, everyone. And that means it's time for our other regular, the very lovely, dropped out of college after being inspired to do stand-up comedy, partly by many forces, herself, her history, my podcast, Bobby Lee.
Black
and
man.
It's always fun to watch her grow, the youthful, the likable, the energetic ball of future comedian stardom that I call Kimberly Congdon, everybody. Here she is, once again.
Hello. Thank you.
Sorry.
Appreciate it. LA has had a really weird effect on my faith because I still pray a lot, but now that I live here, I also smoke a lot. And I don't know if you've ever prayed high, but for me, I get misdirected. Like, I just go in a completely different direction. I'm like, dear God, thank you for everything. Forgive me for my sins, blah, blah, blah. Also, that $100 bill I put in the offering on Sunday, it was supposed to be a 10. So if I could get some change, it'd be nice. And then I get pissed because he's ignoring me, and that's just rude. I get an attitude. I'm like, hello, I'm your daughter. He's just like my flesh father.
I love the word flesh father. That's such a funny word.
That's what I used
it's
to call
just
my flesh
like
light.
My flesh father. Oh, that's so funny. That's a lot of setup. Once you make the turn on the ignoring thing, you gotta keep that short. And the front end of it was what was the first part before that?
Yeah, you could probably just say, "Hey, I went to." Man, I went to church the other day.
Like praying high.
You get high. Did
I
you
went
get,
to church high.
Did you say that you went to church high?
No, I said that I prayed high. That was a true story. I accidentally put a $100 bill in the offering and couldn't go back.
Yeah,
and get
you should explain it like a true story and just make it real quick. I can't believe what happened to me last Sunday.
Own it. Own it. Yeah. Right. Don't tiptoe around because like, well, the difference between me and this. No. You did it.
And then you have that true story to go off of. So then, you know, it's almost like it'll prove to you how real he is, because if he's really real and he sees everything, then he knows that I deserve $90 back out of that.
Yeah.
Maybe say you went to your pastor first, and then he wouldn't like give you the money, so you're like, can I speak to your supervisor?
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot you can do.
I wanted to add a few things maybe to it. I wanted to do something about, I don't even know.
No, you got it. I mean, just listen to this.
About how everyone expects God's voice to be, like, really big and manly, but what if when he actually replied, it was like, well, listen, Kim, you've been really bad lately.
Yeah, you know,
like,
mix it all in, right in that.
Yeah.
But he has to say something funny.
Yeah.
You know? It can't just be.
And a gay lisp.
Yeah.
Right.
Cool.
But, keep rocking. That's Kimberly Congdon. That's at Kimberly Congdon on Twitter. New 60 seconds every week from both of our regular ladies, the great at Sarah Dresses and at Kimberly Congdon. Tweet at them and support them, as always, as the powerful Kill Tony, Death Squad, everything always does. Iron Patriot on Twitter kills it. He's at Comic Patriot on Twitter. Will Hunter Show, correct? Will, you have anything coming up that you want to promote?
No.
No?
I can't think. I don't know. Maybe.
Coming up next is we're in September 16th at the in Phoenix, Arizona.
Stand Up Live. Go to standuplive.com.
Red Band and I will be there. I'm at Tony Hinchcliffe on Twitter. He's at Red Band. Up next, immediately following this, is our favorite show, The Ding Dong Show. The longest running show in Comedy Store history takes place at 10 o'clock here, with the host, the great Don Barris. And follow him on Twitter at Simply Don, and watch The Ding Dong Show. For those of you that are here right now, stay and watch The Ding Dong Show and enjoy it. I'm Tony Hinchcliffe. Have a great day.
Peace.